I would like to thank the ADMM Plus Forum for giving me this opportunity to express India's views and outlook on the regional and international security environment. It is important for us to understand each other and respect our individual views while we strive together towards a common goal in the evolving security environment. I would like to begin with the immediate challenge facing us collectively, COVID-19. The virus is mutating fast and testing our response as we find new variants that are more ineffective and potent. India is just emerging from a second wave that pushed our medical response to the limit. But the disruptive effect of the pandemic is still unfolding. The test is therefore to make sure that the world economy moves on the path of recovery and to ensure that the recovery leaves no one behind. I am convinced that this is only possible if entire humanity is vaccinated. Globally available patent-free vaccines, unhindered supply chains, and a greater global medical capacity are some of the lines of effort that India has suggested for a combined effort. Ladies and gentlemen, never have the Indian concepts of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, the whole world is a one family, and Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina, all be at peace, been more relevant. Today, an outlook that envisages the world as a family will encourage a shared approach. As we look at the present regional and international security environment, new challenges to international peace and security are emerging. The multiple of challenges of today's dynamic and interdependent world cannot be addressed with outdated systems that were designed to deal with trials of the past. Ladies and gentlemen, India calls for a free, open, and inclusive order in the Indo-Pacific based upon respect for sovereignty and territorial integrity of nations, peaceful resolution of disputes through dialogue, and adherence to international rules and laws. India has strengthened its cooperative engagements in the Indo-Pacific based on converging visions and values for promotion of peace, stability, and prosperity in the region. Premised upon the centrality of ASEAN, India supports utilization of ASEAN-led mechanisms as an important platform for implementation of our shared vision for the Indo-Pacific. Ladies and gentlemen, India's engagement with the Southeast Asian region, of which ASEAN has been a primary component, is based on its Act East policy announced by Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi in November 2014. Key elements of this policy are to promote economic cooperation, cultural ties, and develop strategic relationship with countries in the Indo-Pacific region through continuous engagement at bilateral, regional, and multilateral levels. Maritime security challenges are another area of concern to India. The sea lanes of communication are critical for peace, stability, prosperity, and development of the Indo-Pacific region. In this regard, developments in the South China Sea have attracted attention in the region and beyond. India supports freedom of navigation, overflight, and unimpeded commerce in the international waterways. India hopes that the code of conduct negotiations will lead to outcomes that are in keeping with international law, including the UNCLOS, and do not prejudice the legitimate rights and interests of the nations that are not party to these discussions. Brothers and sisters, terrorism and the radicalization are the gravest threats to peace and security that the world is facing today. India shares global concerns about terrorism and believes that in an era when networking amongst the terrorists is reaching alarming proportions, only through collective cooperation can the terror organizations and their networks be fully disrupted, the perpetrators identified and held accountable, and strong measures be undertaken against those who encourage, support and finance terrorism and provide a sanctuary to terrorists. As a member of the Financial Action Task Force, India remains committed to combat financing of terrorism. Cyber threats loom large, as demonstrated by incidents of the ransomware and vanguard attacks and cryptocurrency thefts, and are a cause of concern. A multi-stakeholders approach guided by democratic values with a governance structure that is open and inclusive, and a secure, open and stable internet with due respect to sovereignty of countries would drive the future of cyber space. Brothers and sisters, building upon our 2004 tsunami experience, India has undertaken a wide range of HADR operations. India has remained one of the first to respond in times of distress in the immediate as well as extended neighborhood of India. As a founding member of the Heads of Asian Coast Guard Agencies meeting, India seeks to enhance capacity building through collaboration in the areas of maritime search and rescue. India shares a deep connect with ASEAN and has continued its active engagement in many areas contributing to regional peace and stability, particularly through ASEAN-led mechanisms such as East Asia Summit, ASEAN Regional Forum and ADMM Plus. The India-ASEAN strategic partnership has been strengthened by virtue of flourishing cultural and civilizational links and enhanced people-to-people cooperation. India continues to attach importance to ASEAN's centrality and unity in ensuring peace and stability in the region. Brothers and sisters, finally, I would like to conclude by thanking Brunei Darussalam, the chair of the ADMM Plus 2021, for the flawless conduct of the event despite the restrictions imposed by the pandemic. I also thank all of you for a patient hearing. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.